Assalamualaikum and hi. So, today we are going to look at a new chapter, chapter 9, Simple Harmonic Motion, or we call it as SHM. Okay, the first subtopic here is 9.1, Kinematics, Simple Harmonic Motion, where there are 5 learning objectives in this subtopic. However, in this video, we are going to look at subtopic, learning objective 9.1A, which is to explain the simple harmonic motion. In our next video, we'll be looking at how to solve the problem related to simple harmonic motion displacement equation and to derive equation velocity, acceleration and energy, and also to emphasize the relationship between the total SHM energy and the amplitude, and to apply velocity, acceleration, kinetic energy and potential energy for simple harmonic motion. So, to look at the first learning objective, explain simple harmonic motion, we're going to look at what is periodic motion is first before we look at simple harmonic motion. Okay, periodic motion is a motion of an object that regularly returns to its given position after a fixed time interval. Okay, so wherever you go, whatever you do, you will come back to the same position once after a certain period of time. For example, we have Earth moving around the Sun. Okay, when the Earth is moving around the Sun, it's going to complete one cycle in that particular time interval. Okay, and that process occurs every single time. This is an example of a periodic motion. With a little thought, we can identify several types of periodic motion in everyday life. In this chapter, we are going to study a special kind of periodic motion which occur in mechanical system. So, we are going to look at periodic motion where the object that is regularly returned to its given position after a fixed time interval which occur in the mechanical system. This motion is what we call as simple harmonic motion. So, basically, simple harmonic motion is a type of periodic motion. SHM is a periodic motion. It will come back to the same position after a certain time of interval. Alright, so we're going to look at the definition of simple harmonic motion. Alright, the definition of simple harmonic motion is very long actually. It started from this point here until this here. Okay, it started from simple harmonic motion is defined blah 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 until this particular point. However, I've divided that into 3 different chunks here so that we can understand the definition better. So, simple harmonic motion is defined as the periodic motion without loss of energy in which the acceleration of a body is directly proportional to its displacement from the equilibrium position and it is directed towards equilibrium position but in the opposite direction with displacement. Okay, this is very long to digest. So we are going to look at it chunk by chunk. So the first part here is we are going to understand the simple harmonic motion is a periodic motion without loss of energy. Okay, so SHM, what is SHM? The keyword here is it is a periodic motion with no loss of energy. And then the next part here is in which the acceleration of the body is directly proportional. So whatever this sentence is trying to explain here is the acceleration is directly proportional to who? To the displacement from the equilibrium position. So basically, acceleration is directly proportional to the displacement. So the first part here is, it is a periodic motion with no loss of energy. And then next, the acceleration of a body is directly proportional to the displacement. And then finally, it is directed towards equilibrium position but in the opposite direction with the displacement. It here refers to the acceleration. So the acceleration is in the opposite direction to the displacement. Okay, so basically, simple harmonic motion is a periodic motion with no loss of energy where the acceleration is directly proportional to the displacement. However, the acceleration is in the opposite direction to the displacement. Okay, remember, it is a periodic motion. No loss of energy. In that particular motion, the acceleration here is directly proportional to x, directly proportional. So, which means A increase, x is going to increase. X decrease, A is going to decrease. Okay, however, they are in the opposite direction to each other. However, they are opposite to each other. This is the definition of simple harmonic motion. Alright, this is the equation that we can get the based on the definition of simple harmonic motion, where the acceleration is directly proportional to the displacement but in the opposite direction. So what we have here is the acceleration directly proportional to the displacement. The negative sign here indicates in the opposite direction here. So when we convert this proportionality into equation, we can get A here, acceleration is equals to negative omega square x. Negative omega square x. Or by general equation, acceleration is basically differentiation of the velocity, which is basically the differentiation of the displacement. d2x over dt square. Because dv, v pula is dx over dt. Betul tak? So you differentiate your displacement twice, you will get your acceleration. So differentiate displacement dua kali akan dapat acceleration. So you have acceleration equals to something. To get velocity, what you do, you differentiate the displacement. Okay, to get acceleration, kita differentiate the velocity sebenarnya. Betul tak? Tapi velocity ni datang dari mana? Differentiation of the displacement. So differentiate displacement dua kali. Okay, so this is the equation for simple harmonic motion. Okay, so A is equals to negative omega square x. A is the acceleration of the body. Omega here is the angular frequency, frequency of the angular term. And x here is the displacement from the equilibrium position. Okay, these are a few examples of simple harmonic motion. The first one is the pendulum oscillation. This is very similar to the experiment you have done. Experiment 5, simple harmonic motion, yes. Where you oscillate your pendulum. Initially, it was the this position, 0. And then you pull it to here. Okay, you pull it to here. And then what you do is you release. After you release, you took the time taken for it to come back here. Okay, you release the ball. It went to the left. It did not stop here. Okay, it did not stop here. It comebacks here. Okay, and then this process continue. This process continue. However, in the experiment that you have conducted, kalau kita tak berhentikan pendulum itu, the pendulum will eventually stop after a certain time sebab dia ada loss of energy. Tapi dalam kes kita, kita punya simple pendulum oscillation ini, kita assume there is no loss of energy. So, dia akan sentiasa kembali ke kedudukan yang asal after a certain short time of interval itu. Next adalah frictionless horizontal spring oscillation. So, let's say you have a spring here. The spring here is unstretched or uncompressed here. Okay, so your object is attached at this end. At this particular point, your displacement is 0. And then you stretch the string, you pull the string. You're going to displace your object by x. And then you're going to compress the spring. Bila kita compress, you're going to displace the object by negative x, contoh. Okay, next adalah vertical spring oscillation. Sama je konsep macam horizontal. Cuma kali ni objek kita tengah berdiri. This is an unstretched ataupun uncompressed spring. So you do not have any displacement. X is equals to 0. Once you stretch it down, you're going to displace your object by x here. Lepas tu you compress dia naik ke atas, you're going to displace the object by negative x dekat sini. Okay? Okay, important concept in simple harmonic motion. Important concept. There are few thing atau few term that kita kena faham. The first thing here is the point of equilibrium. This is something very, very important. Point of equilibrium is the fixed point x is equals to 0. A point where the velocity is maximum. Velocity is maximum and the acceleration of the body undergoing oscillation is 0. Alright, next is the amplitude. Okay, the amplitude here, maximum magnitude of the displacement from equilibrium. Maksudnya, your object is going to have displacement. X sama dengan kosong bila you have not displaced it. And then let's say you stretch dia, you stretch, you're going to get a certain, let's say you stretch to 1 cm. You stretch lagi pergi 3 cm. You stretch lagi pergi 5 cm. Let's say the maximum stretching here is 10 cm. This 10 cm ini paling maximum. After this, tak boleh tarik dah. This one, we call it as the amplitude, the maximum displacement. The maximum displacement. Tapi kita tengok pada magnitude sahaja, only the value. So it doesn't matter you're going to stretch it to the right ataupun to the left. Yang penting paling maksimum kita boleh stretch adalah sampai 10 cm. That is amplitude. And then next we have a period, T. Period is the time taken for one complete oscillation. So we know T is the symbol we use for period, is equals to 1 over frequency, and the unit here is the second. And then we have frequency, number of oscillation in 1 second. Maksudnya how many oscillation that you can make in that particular 1 second. So basically frequency is the reciprocal of your period, 1 over T. And the unit here is S, negative 1, or hertz. And then finally is the angular frequency, omega, is the number of oscillation per unit time. Number of oscillation per unit time. So your omega here is 2 pi divided by the period itself, or 2 pi multiplied with the frequency is also equals to V over R. This is to relate your linear term with your angular term. This equation we have encountered in chapter 6 itself. V is equals to R omega. You just rearrange to get omega is equals to V over R. The unit for angular frequency is radian per second.